但是呢，哦，你做常客吼，因为吼，咱无要请一个机会真标榜吼，因为这拢是真出名的讲师吼，啊，介绍真无用啊，所以呢，我伫个名单中间呢，第一个就是啥物啊？你知无？
就这个
排第一个就是 Paul Scott Wilson 吼，伊是世界级的讲师吼，所以我想讲吼。机会真少但是呢，咱放伫祈祷，看咱有法度无？感谢上帝，拄好咱中间，同工中间，黄文勇牧师，伊就是即间新学院毕业，也是伊的学生。啊，我着甲伊联络，我讲你感觉即个教授讲啊，迄就是我是伊的学生吼，我着拜托伊讲，啊，无你敢代表咱北边教乡甲伊邀请，看有可能无吼？啊，咱一个伊的演讲拢是世界级吼，去各所在，啊，拢做真几千人的演讲吼。啊，所以咱一个小小的团队，敢有时间来吼？结果呢，感谢上帝，咱邀请伊随时答应，知影讲啊，咱这款的组织啊，伫各所在才无只才参加，伊真乐意的要来参加，要来帮助咱吼。所以咱真光荣，嘛真感谢上帝，吼，咱这特别的稳定，当邀请着伊啊，我想。我有要去介绍伊个内容，伫咱个所有 program 内底，啊 ，page number two 你会当看到啊一寡介绍伊个内容。啊，我想这时阵啊，要将时间交予咱个 Reverend Dr. Paul Scott Wilson， 啊，我们用牧师啊，要帮咱来欢迎，咱有掌声。
Several years ago, I was at Taiwan Theological School in Taipei.
几年前，伊特别去台北，去台湾神学院底下讲课。
And I gave lectures there, and I was shown around the beautiful country that you have.
从底下看到咱的台湾啊，真水。
And one of the things that impressed me the most was the deep faith of the community there.
讲伊，互伊感觉印象较深，就是咱遐的基督徒因对信仰的坚持。
I know that the Christian journey in Taiwan has not been an easy one.
伊讲台湾的基督徒因的信仰的过程啊是不容易的，伊知。
It has been a journey of living with oppression.
讲台湾捌受过受压迫。
And it has been a journey of living in the shadow of exterior threats to your country.
讲咱捌伫即款互人威胁的阴影下面来咧生活。
And yet you have shown remarkable faith, courage, hope, and dynamic faith.
但伫遐咱有基督徒伫遐显现咱真有盼望。一个坚定的信心。
I want to talk to you today about some of the challenges of preaching in this particular time.
今日要甲恁讲，就是讲，伫这个真挑战的时代，咱要安怎来讲到？
Some of the challenges that we face here in North America are not necessarily identical to what some of you may face in Taiwan.
伫北美洲所遇到的挑战，无一定拄拄啊甲台湾同款。
And by that I mean the challenge of postmodernity.
伫遮我必须讲的，就是即个后现代的挑战。
I want to start by talking about why grace is so important for preaching.
我第先要再强调，就是讲是安怎，即稳定是足面啊重要，伫咱咧讲道时。
First of all, let me give you a simple definition of grace.
叫我先甲恁做一个真简单的稳定的定义。
Grace puts the burden on God。
伊讲稳定是互上帝有一种负担。
And God has accepted that burden in Christ。
啊，上帝有接受这款的负担啊，伫基督的内底。
Grace is what God does.It's how God empowers us. It's free.
一种稳定是上帝荷兰啊，荷兰一款的稳定，互我们有这个快乐。
There's nothing that we can do to buy God's grace.
讲咱袂当去买上帝稳定。
Nothing that we can do to earn God's grace.
也毋是咱去赚来。
It is a gift.
那是上帝的礼物。
And it is a gift of empowerment.
这是上帝给咱有会当有能力的一款的礼物。
I think it's Second Timothy chapter 1 that speaks about what God has given us as a power.
伊讲伫提摩太后书咧，就讲上帝将这个力量来赏赐我们。
For me, in my own education, my own training to be a minister, this was one of the most important ideas I came across.
这是我家己伫这个受神学教育的时，感觉讲这是上重要对我的一个功课。
Because a lot of my training in ministry and seminary and a lot of my own thinking about sermons had been that it is primarily information I'm communicating.
He said that when I was training in the seminary, a lot of the training was to talk to the people.
I thought that what I was doing in preaching was primarily teaching.
So I was saying, preaching is something like that.
But what I came to understand is that even more important than what we teach is that we communicate a relationship with God. We bring people into relationship with God.Through our preaching.
但是我愈来愈感觉讲，咱咧讲道的时吼，是毋是咧将讲教安怎，是咧会当将咱伫遐咧听的人，敢若共引出来，甲上帝啊发生一个关系。
In other words, we give them an experience of God's grace, not just information about God's grace, but an experience of God's grace.
往回来讲，就是要让这听众会当来得到，不是讲来得到稳定的，就是要通过安尼来让经验上帝稳定伫因的中间。
Most of the men in my family and many of the women are ministers.
伊讲伫我的家庭内底有足侪查甫查某啊，拢是牧师。
And when I was growing up in Western Canada, in Alberta, my grandmother from Ireland would occasionally come to visit us. I always looked forward to my grandmother coming, but there were some mixed feelings about her coming as well. I loved my grandmother, but when she came, she would insist that all of us as children come together for family devotions every day. We didn't normally do that in our house. And I wouldn't have minded, except that she would call us in when I was playing baseball with my friends. And we would open up the publication called The Upper Room. That's a Methodist devotional book. And one of us would read the Bible passage, another would read the prayer, another would read the little story in the book. Well, I didn't really like having to come in from playing baseball. But all my adult life, I have been grateful to my grandmother for those times. She was the woman who taught me more than anybody else. She is the woman who taught me about grace. Her husband, my grandfather, was also a minister. I never met him. And one of these sessions, I asked my grandmother, what was Grandpa Trotter like? What was he like? How did he die? She told me what a wonderful minister he was, and how every week he would work on his sermons in the morning, and in the afternoon he would do visitation, and in the evening he would have meetings at the church. On this particular day, he had been working upstairs in the manse, the house that's owned by the church. He was working on his sermons for Sunday, and he was working in his study. And my grandmother made lunch downstairs, and the lunch was ready, and so she dried her hands and called upstairs, "Thomas, Thomas." And he didn't answer. So she called again, and then she called a third time. And this time she went upstairs, down the hall, to where his study was. The door was closed to his study, which is how he usually worked. So She approached his study and she reached out and was just about to touch the doorknob and open the door.
底下伊开这个门，诶，这个，这个，这个叫做射窗啊，底下进没进去。
And she very distinctly heard a voice, and she didn't know what whose voice that was. It wasn't her husband's, but she heard a voice very distinctly.
底下伊忽然又听到一个声，啊，这个声是真清楚。
And that voice said words from the Bible, "My grace is sufficient unto thee."
伊讲这声是对圣经来，就是讲我的恩典就够够你。
And she opened the door, and she discovered my grandfather had died, and he was slumped over his desk, where he had been working on his sermon.
伊开这个门，伊发觉，讲伊的丈夫就是也讲，伊也趴在桌顶，为甚物？
Because she heard that voice, "My grace is sufficient unto thee," she was sustained throughout the time of grieving.
因为伊有听到这个细细声讲，我稳定的教养给你，这声在伊阿妈的心中，让伊在迄个真悲伤的时刻会当记录过去。
But more than that, she was sustained for the rest of her life, because she always went back to hearing those words. Whenever trouble came, "My grace is sufficient unto thee."
不但伊悲伤啊，丧丧失的时，就是伫伊过来的一生，伊的阿嬷拢因为一句话，可以当伫伊的人生克服各种的困难。
And it gave her great courage, probably too much courage in her older years.
讲可以足大的勇气，会当做代志。
It gave her too much courage, perhaps, because she, it was when she was in her mid-70s that she started to drive a car.
我那么想过坐的勇气，所以七十岁以后都会使开车。
I asked her, I said, "Well, Granny, mid-70s, that's a time where some people think about slowing down. They might even give up their car. And why did you start driving when you were in your mid-70s? She said, "Well, I used to ride my bicycle into town, and I discovered that I was running into the back of cars too often. I thought I would be safer in a car."
伊讲伊细汉的时，拢在骑脚踏车，常常去弄到车。伊讲啊，不如我开车较好。
Well, she is the one who taught me about grace.
伊就是一贯的人啊，教我什么叫做稳定。
Grace, it's not about what we do. It's about what God does that is most important.
稳定不是咱做啥物，是上帝在做，啊，咱得到这款的能力。So
that's where we're going to be going. We're going to be talking about grace. That's why it's important for me. But before we get there, I want to talk about the problems in us preaching grace today.
所以这就是我要讲的主题，但是我要讲这稳定以前我要讲，稳定啊，当时也会让咱啊遇到个问题。
I appreciate that not everyone here is a preacher. Who is not?
刚才这大家拢是咧讲道的人，拢有事啊，有诶，我唔是诶人，也就。Well,
even those of you who are not preachers, what we are talking about is relevant for any kind of Christian teaching.
虽然咱拢不是讲全部所有讲道，但是咱所讲的拢是甲基督教有关的。And
it's relevant for our own spirituality, how we view God.
是予咱的灵性啊，上帝超人。
As I drove along Progress Avenue, I noticed that there are several buildings marked Grace. There's another church called Grace. There's a Grace Community Center down here. There's a Grace Church.
我行这条Progress这条路，是看到足侪所在拢有讲写这文旦这个字。
But I also understand that because of the history of suffering and oppression, that Grace is a harder subject in Taiwan than it might be in other places.
但是我也了解，讲在台湾这款的历史的过程当中，咱可能还是讲其他受特别的人的所在，正歹去了解什么是稳定。
Let's think about the world, the time of the world, as being in two pieces. The first piece is the modern piece. So, here in North America, what we consider as the modern is anything that has happened since the Enlightenment. Since the
Reformation.
In the modern period, up to the present, there has been great emphasis on knowledge and science. There's been a sense that of understanding that everything should be united and everything should conform to a certain unity. The postmodern world is a world that is in reaction to the modern world. The postmodern world does not accept the assumptions of the modern world. It's mistrustful of religion, of ideology, of any unified system. So we have two worlds now existing alongside each other. One is the modern world, which represents much of the status quo. And there is the postmodern world that is largely critical of everything that has gone before.
So
here in North America, we've seen a great decline in the mainline denominations. And that decline can largely be explained. I mean, there are many ways of explaining it, but it can largely be explained in terms of this shift from the modern to the postmodern.
就是亲像这个后现代啦，啊，兴起啊，这个现代人啊，这个衰微。This
may not be as pronounced in your own communities as it is in other communities in North America.
讲这个不一定是适合在不同款的这个团体吼，啊，不适合在咱的台湾。
And I say that in part because I know that there is great there continues to be great respect for elders in your cultures.
지금 在咱台湾的文化内底，咱对这老人非常的尊敬。
But in our own churches, if you want to see what the division is between the modern and the postmodern, we only need to look to our young people.
如果咱伫，就是咱北美洲的教会，你若要看讲是伊是现代还是后现代，啊，你就看讲偌济青年伫教会，你就知影。
The same is probably true in many of your young people.
讲可能伫别个所在有哪样情况。
Our young people are not interested in religion.
阮的青年伫北美洲，伊无足兴趣即个宗教。
Or rather, they aren't interested in organized religion. They say they may be religious, but not belonging to anything.
伊讲，伊可能会讲啊，我有啦有兴趣宗教，但是我无属于对一个组织的教会的。
I'm making sweeping generalizations here about our youth, and it's only to make a larger point.
讲我伫这同个时间咧，做一比较，是讲，绝对是，绝对是。
So for instance, in our young people, goodness is relative. It's not an absolute. Where in the modern world, and with thinking traditionally, goodness was an absolute and it belonged to everyone.
好，阿妈有看看经验的，相对。So
for instance, if we preach about what is good, a young person might respond, "Well, that's just your version of what is good. What's good for this group may not be good for this group."
亲像讲咱来讲道来讲，啊，这就是真好。啊，这后现代青年呢，伊讲，嗯，啊，这是对恁这群的人好嘞，不一定对另外一群的人不一定好。That's
a postmodern response. Another thing that we would find with our young people is that truth is questioned. I think we often assume that what we say is true corresponds to a certain reality that exists out there. But our young people would have their own version of what is true.
但是这青年，因有自己诶对真理诶想法，有无同款诶看法。So
there's goodness and truth. We have difference about. We also have difference about what is knowledge.
啊，不但真理啊，不但好，咱对迄个知识啊，我拢无同款诶看法。For
us traditionally, knowledge is. Knowledge is that which is more important than anything else to know.
以传统来讲，咱拢就咪讲哦，你知识是比其他物件更加重要。And
many young people today would say, "Well, you're just saying what's important, but we have our own version of what is important."
但是在青年来讲，啊，你就咪讲这真重要，因就咪讲，阮咧讲的重要是像你讲的那物件。
What do you call knowledge? We may not call knowledge.
您讲这是知识，我们不讲这是知识。
In our universities in North America, we're seeing a big decline in the number of students enrolling, for instance, in history.
讲在这北美洲的大学内底有足些学校内底，即嘛，伊个读起来读书的人嘛，所以减少。
They aren't interested in history. The interesting things don't lie in the past. I'll show you where the interesting things lie. This is where the interest is. It's in the right now and in the future, coming at any moment.
伊讲伫遮，即手机内底就遐载物件啊，有将来要看。
The past，
伊讲过去的代志无重要。
A fourth area where young people differ, may differ, is in terms of authority. Authority is seen as something that supports the status quo.
And
young people are interested in change. They don't see that the status quo is necessarily helping them to get jobs. In the United States, the presidential election, Bernie Sanders has been so successful because he appealed to change it with the young people. So the final thing is that skepticism is rampant. People are very skeptical, and there's a challenge to take apart anything that is given and not to see the value. Alright, let's say for a minute that these changes are taking place in some of your communities as well. And if this change isn't taking place dramatically in this generation of your youth, it will probably take place in the next one. One could say that the problem is with postmodernity. That is, that the problem that the church faces is in countering the effects of the postmodern. But there's another way of looking at it that I want to share with you. What if the problem is not post-modernity? What if the problem is modernity? For young people, post-modernity is not a problem because it's their everyday world. They don't expect everything to form one unity. There are all kinds of things happening in the world, and they can plug in wherever they want. So here's the challenge. As a church that is largely shaped by modern notions, we can either keep on preaching in modern ways, or we can make a shift. I think that we need to make a shift. I think we need to be addressing our young people in ways that will capture the vision they have of the world. I think our modern notion of preaching has been largely teaching and communicating information.
甲因教，还是讲讲革命啊，真侪资料。
And I don't think that young people inherently have an interest in that information.
啊，伊就袂讲青年人拢无兴趣遮物件。
But I do think that young people have a very keen interest in religious experience.
但是我不相信啊，咱遮青年人伊对宗教的经验，因非常的有兴趣。
I think they are hungry for greater meaning and purpose.
因底下的对这个意义啊，追求迄个目的。
I think they're hungry for God.
底下那个追求的。
They may not say that they're hungry for God. But you know, when young people turn to drugs or alcohol, that is really looking for God in the wrong place.
伊讲，伊可能袂讲啊，我咧找上帝。但是你若看咧饮酒吼，啊，你就知影讲吼，因是咧找什么物件，但是找了唔对，伊就对。
If we were to keep on preaching in modernist ways, we might end up being like the person who speaks to the one who can't hear.By shouting.
如果咱能够继续用现代的方式来咧讲道的时候，就咱就讲咱啊，就爱讲足大声，啊人拢无咧听，但是我直直讲，直直讲足大声，但是无人咧听。
Just shout louder.
伊干那大声讲了咧。
But it probably won't make a difference.
但是可能无什么效果。
We can't simply say.Come to our preaching with the understanding this is the truth and you have to accept it.
伊讲咱家讲讲啊，这阮咱家来当讲就是讲啊，这就是真实，这是真理啊，请恁啊，恁来当。
This doesn't mean that we abandon the truth as we understand it, but rather that we take care to communicate it in ways that will be effective.
伊讲，这意思唔是讲咱都爱放弃咱咧认为讲说是真理的物件，但是咱都爱真有效地将这个咱认为真理有效地来传达出去。
Probably nothing characterizes the postmodern more than the questioning.
这个后现代的一个特色就是讲。对这物件拢会家提出挑战，提出问题。
The postmodern always questions basic assumptions.
即个后现代拢永远都咧挑战，还是咧提出问题对现在的这个代志，还是现在
情形。It doesn't take things for granted.
你无认为这是当然的。
In other words, when we preach, if we're going to be preaching.In ways open to the postmodern young people, we need to be explaining why we hold certain positions.
我为了讲，就是讲咱若要甲这个后现代青年底下来讲道的是，咱袂该干那讲讲，我就是安的，伊都爱讲一个理由，讲一个代志，互因会当来说服。
We can't just say this is the truth, accept it.
咱袂当讲啊，这就是真理啦，你得照安尼安尼接受就好。
We have to say, this is what I believe is the truth, and these are the reasons that I have for believing.
我袂当解讲讲，这就是我相信的真理，啊，这是安那我接受真理的原因。
We have to give testimony to our own faith.
咱得爱托咱的这个，爱提出咱的见证，咱有见证。
So I want to give a different, I want to give us a different image of what the preacher might be like in the postmodern time.
我直接要给恁一个印象，就是讲这后现代人咧讲到安怎讲。
In the modern time, the preacher is going to be a teacher and is going to have maybe 3 points to the sermon plus a poem.
现代式的讲道就是拄拄啊，今仔有人讲讲啊，咱讲道是讲第一点、第二点、第三点。
In the postmodern era, we're still going to be teaching, but it's not going to be primarily addressed to the mind.
但是后现代的讲道，伊讲咱话咧，你讲讲解啊，你讲教导什么物件，但是无基本上固定讲啊，一至三点。
We're going to try and speak to the mind, and to the heart, and to the experience, and to the emotions. We're not just going to present points, we're also going to tell stories. Stories communicate points in their own way.
即讲讲故事本身就是一个真好诶沟通诶方式。
And people like stories.
人就爱听故事。
It's much easier to hear somebody tell about an experience in stories than it is to hear a lecture.
即讲讲故事人较会听，你也伫遐个演讲吼，无人要听。
Lectures and points give information.
He gong dia kai en gang a chi si gong a gui diam ho yi zhe dong xi de kai.
And points are still good, but how much better is it if we can provide people an experience through the preaching of God's reality?
He gong gong gui diam mo na xi ho la, han xi gong guo ka ho de xi gong e dang xiong li ye jing yan.通过你的生活在那个所在来给人知。
So I want us to think about other images that we might have for preachers in the postmodern time. Think I like to think here in my context of the preacher being a poet in residence.
在这我讲另外要用一个方式来讲后现代人。咧，讲道伊啊，来是讲是，那亲像，那亲像一个诗人啊，一些诗啊。
But we could think of other words too, other terms, a storyteller in residence.
啊，是讲迄个讲故事诶人。
What we're trying to do in preaching, I think, is to communicate the beauty of God's creation.And the wonder of salvation.
底下讲到人就是要将上帝啊创造的这水，还是讲上帝安怎拯救世间人这款的信息传出去。
So we want to point to the wonder and beauty of God's action when God intervenes when people are suffering.
所以底下咱要很指出讲，伫这个真苦难的情形还是世界。啊，上帝的这个稳定啊，上帝的拯救啊，上帝的听啊，有缘伫这所在。
What does it look like? That's a key question. What does it look like? Whatever I'm talking about in preaching, what does it actually look like? Where have I seen mercy? What does mercy look like?
伊讲底下阿边那个将这个物件来个表达出来，啊，这是一个这就是。最困难的所在就是，比如呢，你讲稳定啊，稳定是啥？啊，你要呢用一个故事啊，用一个什么物件来给表达出来，这个是一个上大的问题。
Have you got a picture of mercy that you can put into your teaching or your sermon?
你会当将啊，就是讲啊，稳定啊，但是咧稳定，你用一个图啊来给表现出来。
Here, I'm just thinking of ordinary stories from ordinary life.
啊，伫遮咱咧所讲嘅故事，就是普通嘅人，还是普通嘅代志，普通嘅代志发生伫遐稳定。
So, for instance, perhaps a storekeeper near a school has children who come into the school come into the store every day.And usually, one or two of the children steal something.
迄种亲像啊，就讲伫学校边啊有迄款商店吼，啊，遐囡仔拢会来遮买物件，当遮囡仔淘汰。
And the storekeeper catches a young girl who has just stolen a candy bar.
这个商店的主人啊，底下抓到一个囡仔啊，底下偷的物件。
And he knows her. He knows her from church. He knows her parents.
哎，讲你知影这囡仔对教会来，佮伊也知影老爸老母。
And she's crying and she's worried about all the trouble that she's in.
所以底下这个查某囡仔啊，就底下哭，也讲唔知。
And what does he do? He draws her aside, speaks to her alone, says, don't ever do that again. And be a good person.
好，这个商店的主人无讲安尼，就伊就甲伊摇去边啊，甲伊讲讲，啊，你唔好去做安尼，啊，你这边哦。
And he sends her on her way.
啊，就帮伊走。
Having a picture of mercy is better than having an explanation of mercy.
所以在这里会有一个，就是这款的图面吼，凭讲你多啊解释讲啊，稳定是啥，更加容易互人接受。
So in many ways, what we need to do is we need to become more visual, use images, pictures in our sermons.
所以我会来讲，就是讲你会当，互人来用你的目睭吼，会当看到啊，这款片会更加好看的。
So I want to talk about a revolution in preaching that has taken place in North America and in parts of Europe. We can call this the old homiletic and the new homiletic. And the old homiletic is very much this modern notion of preaching that we were talking about. Three points, maybe a poem.
伊讲啊，旧个就是用现代，他拄仔讲个现代新个方式来讲道方法。
It has a mechanical kind of structure. It's kind of like building blocks.
即款个方式就是敢若真机械式，啊，已经甲伊囥伫一个壳内底啊，无停袂停袂动即款个方式。
Those kinds of sermons or classes that you might teach are often deductive.
这款的方式是，那亲像较古典式的，啊，你是干那等待演绎，啊，演绎出来。
They assume that religious experience is universal instead of just being specific to particular contexts.
就咪讲这个宗教的经验是普遍性，普遍拢安尼，伊无去注重迄个个别单独诶一款诶无同款诶宗教经验。
For example, a sermon on First Thessalonians 1:5, our message of the gospel came to you not in word only, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit with full conviction.
伊接受到你解，他都讲诶，即个经文内底就是讲。上帝话是对有关联，是对圣灵来的。
So if we were preaching on that text in a modern way, we would probably have four points. The first point would be the gospel comes in word.
所以咱用现代式来了，讲道时咱可能会讲哦啊。这个福音是对话来。
The gospel comes in power. The gospel comes in the Holy Spirit. And the gospel comes with full conviction. And that would be a good sermon. And many of us would love to hear that sermon. But for many people, maybe young people in particular, they might not be interested in that. We have to create the interest. We have to create the interest by tapping into their experience.
And I 创造一个，诶，我物件来，互因会当感觉有兴趣。
Or another example is Psalm 23.
另外一个就是诗篇23。
Point one, our paths are dangerous.
伊讲第一点，咱诶路是危险。
Point two, the Lord is our shepherd.
伊是主是咱诶牧者。
Point three, there is nothing to fear.
第三点，免惊。
Again, that's a good sermon.
这么是真好诶讲道。
But it may not communicate.
但是这不当来互人接受沟通。
It's deductive. It sets things out. One, two, three. You tell people what you're going to say. You say it, and then you say what you've said.
你讲在家里拢讲了了啊。第三、第二、第三点就是安尼，恁就是爱做安尼，阿姐就是安尼。
It's easy to follow.
容易就会当去做。And
it's an excellent teaching model because it gives people three things or four things. Most people can remember three or four things.
你讲这真容易，予人会记得第几点、几点啊？所以足容易记的一个程度。So.
In the 1960s, there was a revolution in preaching in North America.
但是对1960年，1960年以后就是新的当道的风潮。
And that revolution has continued to the present.
啊，这款革命性的当道到今天还继续在进行。
And basically, what it does is it talks about the importance of giving images or pictures to communicate.
这其中一部分就是讲，广告里有什么款的影像啊，用这个图啊来唤起人的注意。
Instead of using reason, point one, point two, point three, to structure the sermon might now be more like a drama or a story that is unfolding.
不是像以前安尼讲哦，第一点、第二点、第三点啊，拢用头壳、用语言来跟伊讲，啊跟伊教，唔是都爱用这图面啊，亲像来啊一个细节吼啊来来慢慢啊来讲故事迄款的来，互人来当去接纳。So
instead of sounding like a lecture, it's going to try and sound more like a conversation.
所以，这款的讲道，唔是讲你讲演讲，啊，从一边咧听，咱就是较熟的，迄个互相啊听人甲讲的人来对了。So,
for instance, after you've made a point in your sermon, you might say, "Well, but I met a young woman this week who seemed to believe the opposite."
啊，情况咱可能会讲啊，一点我讲安尼，但是。 你也使佫讲啊，我嘛有拄到一个人来，我咁款的看法。And
then introduce the congregation through your words to that person. Let us hear her speak.
哦，即卖当家咱会将讲啊，这个人是甚物人，啊，无请伊来讲，也更加可能。Instead
of it all being abstract in the head, we're actually meeting somebody, hearing them speak.
咱唔是讲干咧用头壳讲哦啊，有即款的代志尔，听，咱真正互因通过因的目睭啊来看到即款诶人伊的经验。
Another way of thinking about this kind of form of teaching or preaching is to think of it as organic. A mechanical form, as in the modern sermon, it's kind of like with bricks. You put it here, and then you take another brick, and you put another brick on top of it, and you take a third brick, and you put another brick on top of it. It's kind of mechanical. It's kind of chunky.
이건 현재 시기 감도듯이 나중에 큰 게 중요한 게 중요한 게 되게 섭기라는 지진기하시.
But organic form is something that grows. It has its own life. It has its own development. It grows as you hear it.
유기시에도 지금 진지 치와 지금 꽃이 돼 떠장 아 이게 만만한 만화 신경 아
One of the people in the New Homiletic early on said that the sermon is an idea that grows. In other words, something happens in the course of the sermon. It changes. There's life. It's development. There's attention. You're wondering where is this leading? What's going to happen?
刚刚都是就那亲像啊，就是生命吼，啊，有的生命啊，伊底下有咧叮当，是讲固定的啊，你有当时啊，唔知影讲，哎，伊要走去对。
You may have seen the same sort of thing that we have seen in North America when television came in. When television first started in North America, there was advertising, but the advertising was all just information. It was saying, go down to Rexall drugstore and buy your aspirin there because they know how to take care of
it.
I think we've all seen advertisements on television that are like that. But the revolution that took place in the advertising world was telling stories instead of just giving information. So nowadays, if someone is advertising a headache pill, they're going to tell a story about somebody who has this terrible headache after having sat in a coffee shop next door to where they're tearing down a building. In the United States, one of the most popular programs of the year is the Super Bowl. It's a football game. And people always want to see the commercials. And the reason they want to see the commercials isn't because of the information, it's because they tell stories.
So
one of the One of the key understandings for us in the new homiletic has been that the Word is an event. The biblical Word, the Word of God, is an event, not primarily information. It's something that happens.
一个新的感动，他来给你是讲，上帝话啊，不是干那，互你资讯，互你一个知识，而是互迄个上帝话，正做一项代志发生伫你的生活内底，伫即卖所在。
And where this idea comes from? It's in Genesis 1, where God makes the world by speaking. The words do something. God says, "Let there be light." And there is light.
这个管理是对上帝讲，光啊灯啊灯啊，就会做真济代志，亲像安尼，话加做一个事实，加做一个力量，加做一个运作，对。God's
word changes things. When God speaks, the world is different.
伊讲上帝话改变这世界，上帝讲什么话出来？
And the same should be true in our preaching. There's an eventful quality to our preaching. It's like in Isaiah 55, where in verse 11, which says something like, the word of God goes forth, and it does not return empty or void, but accomplishes the very purpose for which it is sent. So when we preach, for instance, about the power of God's love in somebody's life, there's that word that we have uttered isn't just our own. It's God's word, and we know it is going out and it will accomplish its own purpose. It's not just information, it's a happening, it's an event. So I think when we think about our preaching, we should think of it, of what we are doing as launching an event. This is the beginning of something.
So when we talk about it, we should think of it as what we are doing as launching an event. This is the beginning of something.
People's lives will be transformed because of this. Now, it isn't just enough. For so far, we've just been talking about a change in style. Instead of points, we tell stories or try and develop a kind of plot that moves or grows. But there's another thing that I think is absolutely essential if our preaching is going to reach another generation. And that is, our preaching needs to focus on what God is doing. The actions of God matter. Even if we refuse to testify God will raise up witnesses even from these stones.
讲上帝啊，会咧做工事。
God will raise up witnesses even from these stones. It's a bit weird.
Okay. 伊讲你若拢无讲话啊，上帝对石头哦，伊咪也会讲话啦。上帝咧做工就对。
How do we know anything about God in the Bible? If you, you know, one can think of the Bible as a lot of information. But when you actually ask that question, how do we know anything about God in the Bible? Chances are, for the most part, it's by seeing God act.
讲咱是安怎来知影讲啊上帝啊咧做工呢？啊，伫圣经内底安尼写。啊，咱会当来知影是因为安怎，是因为有看到讲，迄个上帝咧做工的工课真正咧顶当，伫这所在。
People want to know where is God in the world today.
人拢问讲啊，上帝即马伫倒？
And we need to be able to point to where God is.
咱就会使来跟指出讲啊，上帝伫倒？
Our sermons need to show God acting.
咱会感到爱来指出上帝伊伫这个所在的行动。
God's actions are a grace; they're a gift to us.
上帝的恩典是一个礼物给咱。
So, in addition to everything that we've been talking about, there has to be a change of style. There also has to be a focus on God.
除了讲咱在做讲这个。不同款的形式，啊，咧讲到方法以外，伊讲，咱咧讲到的重点、重心，爱放伫上帝。
So I encourage my students that before they start any sermon, they read the biblical text and they decide what is God doing in this text. What is God doing?
所以，伫我教学的时，我教先讲恁那边讲到的时，先读起个经文。然后你爱个爱个去思想，还是去找着讲上帝伫咧经文内底咧做啥
？So it might be Jesus heals the blind man, or God brings Israel out of Egypt.
可能是讲耶稣啊，医治这前面人，还是讲上帝啊，才一些的百姓出来见。
But if we have an action of God.That's an empowering action. We've got something to preach.
伊讲咱人一旦啊指出啊上帝啊伫伊个伊咧做工个时，这是一个真有力个感觉。
It was several years into my teaching that I was wondering why some of the things that I was hearing from my students weren't very powerful.
我咧教册过年中间，我发觉讲啊，是安怎，阿生个讲道拢无讲足力。
And I came to understand that the reason the sermons weren't powerful is because they didn't get to God.
啊，我发觉讲，就是因个讲道内底无上帝咧做工个内底。
They talked about the biblical text, and they talked about contemporary affairs, and they made.Good images and pictures told some good stories, but they didn't get to God.
They were going to get out, young, so Jinze, Tobin, Tanshi, Gong Jinze, and Dai Gosu, Tanshi, Gong de Champagne.
They said what we have to do, but they didn't say what God is doing to empower us.
In Nong Gong, oh, Nando, I am not so, Tanshi, in Gong de Gong, Xiong de.诶，关联啊，伫这个所在安怎做
？They didn't get to grace.
咱因无来到讲到迄个上帝恩典。
So in the coming days, we will be talking about how to do this in a more precise kind of way that will give specific direction.
所以过来，咱能够较有详细来讲，要安怎来做
？My own. Journey to be a minister had a detour.
我家己本身的这个诶，啥物来做事的这款的经历，我也不太明了。
My dad's a minister. I left the church when I was about 16. Returned when I was about 24.
我老爸是牧师，啊，我16岁我拢无来教会，啊，24岁才去当兵。
And what had happened is I was studying in England, and there was a fellow Canadian that I didn't know him very well, but he and I had gone to a poetry reading at the old Vic Theatre in London. I stopped to, on the way home, I stopped to tie my shoe right at a crosswalk. My friend walked in. They have crosswalks in London, the same as we have crosswalks here in Toronto. If you're in the crosswalk, the traffic is supposed to stop. My friend walked ahead and he was in the crosswalk. And as I tied my shoe, I could hear a car approaching and I shouted to my friend, "Look out." I thought he was safe, but when the car came, it hit him head on. He was carried down the road about 100 yards, and the police, right in front of a police station, he was taken to hospital. And his parents were in Canada, and I didn't know them, but I knew where he lived, so I went to his place and got their address and phoned them. He was in a coma, and they came immediately, of course, and I met them at the airport and took them to his apartment and then took them to the hospital. And there they received the news that he had severe brain damage. I wasn't going to church at the time, but I'd grown up in the church, and I thought, well, maybe I should take them down to the chapel. So we went down to the chapel, and I turned on the light switch. It was a dingy room in the basement of the university hospital. And I looked around, it was so uninviting, so cold. I said, I thought to myself, somebody better say a prayer. And then I realized that somebody might be me. So I said a prayer. I don't remember what I said. I don't even know what I meant. I wasn't going to church at the time. My first real prayer was 3 months later. David had been flown back to Canada, back to Toronto, and I had come home for a holiday and went to see him in the hospital. The swelling was gone. He was sitting in a chair. He was looking out at the park. And he looked well. But when I spoke to him, there was no one there. His eyes did not move. There was no response. That night I was going through a shopping center and there was a wishing well. So I reached into my pocket to find a coin. I was going to throw it into the wishing well, and I thought, well, this is stupid. If I'm going to make a wish, I might as well say a prayer. So I said my first prayer, and I still don't know if this is a good prayer to say, that it's the prayer I said. I said, please God, either heal David so his parents won't suffer, or let him die.
So what did he do?
There was no reason to think that he wasn't physically okay. Physically okay.
In the
But the next day he died. And for me, that wasn't proof of God, but it was like a burning bush. I had to stop and look and listen and see if God was there. And I was a little disappointed to conclude that in fact there is a God. I wanted to live my life the way I was going to live it. But it is by God's grace. And that's what I was looking for in the sermons that I heard of my students. I wanted to hear something about God, the power of God to change lives, to make a difference. So my hope is that your teaching and your preaching will be like a burning bush to those who hear it.
所以我的愿望就是咱的感觉，咱的教育，还是讲咱的讲道，就亲像迄个迄个烧吼，一个气体咧烧，甲管烧啊，但是啊，迄个气体无烧起，一款
而且。In it, they will not just get information about God, but they will experience the reality of God in and through your words.
底下咱是咧将在自信上帝话，毋是变作一个信息物件，伊真侪我诶，咱上帝伫咱的中间咧做工诶一款的经验。
I am very grateful to the Reverend Danny Nguyen. He's such a good translator. I don't think I said that. Any questions?
I'm going to say something with you. I'm going to ask you a question.